112th level female Rex right in the area. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing some things from the Ark Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server. And I'm red. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day, but I'm all red. I think that Miola painted us red. If you remember in the past, we were doing stuff and things. We were like, blah, blah, blah. This is stuff and things. And then we were like, we'd paint somebody, paint them. And then we would run away and stuff would happen. And other things, we'd tan something. But today, we are red. And actually looks kind of good. I kind of like the red. Kind of looks hot. Kind of doesn't match the theme we're going for, though. It does a little bit match these guys. We got our new birds, Tonnage and Poundage. And last night, I found this guy. I did it off camera. His name is Ingot. And he is our new Anki. Let me show you his stats. Check it out, peeps. Level 157, 3360 health, 560 stamina, whatever. Oxygen, blah, blah, food, whatever. I pumped his weight a little bit. His weight's really low. 405 right now, and I do believe it only goes by like 20 points. And melee damage, 419, so that's really high. And he has a base movement speed stat, 150, so he's pretty baller. We're doing really good with him. And he's going to be our Anki that we're going to use over up at our Mountain Forge area, which we've got yet to build. And I think we might start working on that today. I want to get the forge done. So let me go ahead and jump on to gameplay real quick and kind of give you an idea of what the stuff and things are. The update on the metal stuff and things. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 500, 600, 1,000, 1,500, and a little bit more of cementing paste now, which I've been working on here and there. We've got 63 more inside of there. And then the metal department, let us pop over here and just take a look. This isn't going to be an issue, really, after we get the new forge thing going. We're not going to have to worry about metal as much anymore, but we'll just pop. Actually, I'll just squirt right down here. Ugh. So this chest, completely full. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,000, 7,400. And then do we have any more on you right here? Yeah, we do. Nail the day scammy stuff. Oh, you got some more weight. Look at that, homie. So 7,619. And I'm going to take a wild guess and say I think there's even more metal up inside these refining forges. Nailed it, ace. It can't be stopped. We can carry three. Wait, what? We're getting no weight indicator. Oh, it's because I had my display off. Can we carry 200 metal at a time now? I think we can. Yeah, at least that. So we can actually just come down in here and then squirt this right into hardware and do that. But anywho, so the point of this beginning part is not only have we crossed off a bunch of things off our Toto list, but we also have crossed a bunch of things off our total list and are doing amazing at other things like taming the new things and getting ready for the finding forge. I got a little bit more metal in there. So, also, I just want to start off, as I always do, by saying thank you guys so very much for all your likes and support on the videos. I really do appreciate it. If you guys like this video, don't forget. It's very important and it really helps me out. Smash the like button for me, peeps. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more stuff and things. So, all right, we've got the metal stuff and things going. We got some cementing paste. I'm thinking what we're going to do in order to make our forgy thing, probably right around in this area, we could head out and start making some stuff. So I'm thinking maybe like 20 stone ceilings and maybe 40 stone pillars or something like that to start off with today. We really can't use Ingot to get that stuff because he's just going to get a ton of flint. So we're probably going to have to do it manually. That is after we dye our armor back, which was something we got to do here. There we go. Oh, so much better. All right, so I'm going to dye the armor back, and then I'm also going to start getting the stuff and things ready, and then we'll meet up at the mountain. There we go. And I will be our bees, peeps. Where are you, bottom bits? Nailed it. And we're back, and I got some stuff and things all set up on Poundage. Ready to rock and roll. We've got 57 stone pillars, 25 ceilings. This had to make a little bit extra. 5 refining forges. I'm figuring 600 a piece. That would be good. We got a smithy. Just one mortar and pestle is all we really need. A couple of storage boxes and a preserving bin. And we're ready to rock and roll on him. So I'm going to take him and we're going to take gameplay up to the area where we're going to do the new forge. Come on, Poundage. Let's do this, man. So while we're on the way up here, I thought we'd talk about a couple of different things that are some stuff and things that are happening on the channel right now. Just recently, we hit 500,000 subscribers. I talked about it in a video the other day. I kind of can't believe it. It's been really amazing. You know, a lot of you guys don't know, or a lot of you guys are new, and you know, the channel's been around for about, I don't know, 4 years now. But just in the last 4 months or so, has really, really changed, and Ark has really changed him. And so it's been an amazing thing. I think Drax just died. Oh, it looks like Z's with him. So it's been an amazing thing, and it's just unbelievable. I can't thank you guys enough for all your support that you've been giving me. It's just crazy, and I can't really believe it. But so anyway, we're going to be doing a 500,000 subscriber special, and in there, we're going to talk about a couple of things. We're going to talk about Brian. We're going to talk about Minecraft. I know there's been a lot of questions about that, and for a minute there, I'll talk about this in the special as well. There was a little bit of, like, animosity. There was, like, some animosity, and there was a little bit of, like, some infighting in the comment sections, and so I feel like I was kind of waiting a little bit for stuff and things to die down there before I brought this back up again. But now we're definitely ready to talk about it. I'm going to tell you guys all about what the plans are for the channel and stuff and things like that. But also, some other things that are really cool are going to be happening pretty soon is that my wedding anniversary is coming up in a couple of days here. And I just went out today and I got my wife an anniversary gift. Secret anniversary gift thing for her. And I hope I did a good job. I feel like I probably did a really good job. She'll probably just be excited that I did anything at all because... I'm pretty forgetful when it comes to dates. I'm a typical dude. I don't do well with dates, but I do remember this one. It's a pretty easy one. It's only been 1 year so far, so I haven't had a chance to forget about it. But we're gonna be doing that. Now I'm wondering if right over here. You know, right over here would probably be a really good spot. There's a little bit of some activity here. Just trying to see where a good spot would be. I guess right over here too. You could come right down the mountain and walk right onto the platforms that are right there. Oh, crap. You know what I didn't make? I didn't make one foundation. I need a foundation for this as well. But yeah, so my anniversary is coming up in a little bit. So that's going to be really cool. And then at the end of the month, at the very first week of November, end of October, first week of November, I'm actually going to be going on vacation to visit some friends down in Florida. So I'm going to take some time off, which I don't do very much. So that's going to be really exciting, and I hope to be able to do some vlogs when I do that and just kind of show you guys what we're doing. And nothing major, we're just going to head down, relax, we're going to go to Disney World, do some stuff and things, and eat at some restaurants and do that, and that's going to be pretty much it. So, you know, I'm kind of concerned about this area. So anyway, I guess maybe just let me wrap it up. That's the update, just so you guys kind of know in my real life what's going to be going on and some other stuff and things. You know, before we start talking about the area here, the other thing too is, I had a question for you guys. This is my question for you guys. Hold on. Let's go like this. Let's go like this. Let's go like this. Question for you guys. If you could download a dinosaur into the real world, how do you think that would happen? Here in Ark, we do it through the towers. But I'm not sure if you were going to do it in the real world, how would you do it? I'm not really sure. I know it's an odd question, but it's just something I've been thinking about. So you guys, let me know what you think in the comment section of the down there. How would you download a dinosaur into the real world? But, all right, so over here, trying to take a look at where we're going to do this thing. And really, I almost kind of want to bring Ingot over here to see if he can even climb up here. I guess we could just walk with, yeah, I mean, if these guys can climb it, Ingot's going to be able to climb it. So he could climb this area. I don't want to take out too much of, I don't want to, by building, make too much of the metal not respawn. But at the same time, there's so much of it here, it almost doesn't matter. So then the other concern becomes, what about, now all the way down there, I don't think that you could get down there and then get back up on the Anki. I really want it to be so that he can get up here, just because these metal nodes are the most amazing metal nodes. They're the most dense. They're going to pack the most punch. So, but I am concerned about the Sabertooths and the Argies too. So we could raise it up off the ground so the Sabertooths can't get up there. But that doesn't help us with the RGs at all. I don't think I'm ready to do a turret or anything like that. Like, I just don't know if we have the supplies to get all that stuff and things done. We've got enough gas to get a Jenny going for that, I guess. But, yeah, so I'm thinking right here. Like, there's a couple of metal nodes right there. But I'm thinking we could just build this right here. And this would be a really good spot for it. So actually, let's go ahead and let's unfollow Poundage. All right. And so go ahead and land, homie. And then I'm actually just going to come down here. I'm going to grab some stuff to make one thatch foundation. I need a foundation. I don't have any stuff and things to do that. So I'm going to come down here and do that. I'm going to get a little bit of the building done for the new forge. Now BRBs, peeps. And we're back. We've got our forge. And what I decided to do was this spot right here. If you take a look, you can kind of walk right up there. Oh, there's another Anki right there. Be a super high level one. 12. All right. Don't be then. So right here, this is kind of like the highest point over at this little spot. So I'm thinking if we just kind of do something right here, this will work out really good. So we should be able to go like this, and like this. And then what I was thinking about doing was just making it. Oh, we can't place over there, but we can do over here, like a so. I was thinking about just making it 5x5. That should be like enough room, like 5x5x2. Maybe we can make it 3 deep. And then we can just take our pillars, just like this and like this. And we place that one 2 out. So we can go like this, and then we'll have to do another one. Are you going to place underneath there, buddy? Like that, like so. And we should be able to now, maybe. Let's go ahead and place these and these. And we should be able to demolish this. Actually, no. Well, yeah, we're going to lose one floor. All right, I think the one right behind there is going to break. Yeah, we lost that guy. That's all right. That's fine. And then we'll go like this and like so. So we're good to go. And I'm not really worried about the pillars poking through in this instance. I think that'll be fine. So we're going to go... Oh, we're already out of floors. Or ceilings, I said. But we have a huge amount more. Kind of, sort of. All right, so we got 13 more like so. And then we should be able to actually just... I thought we could. Oh, we could walk up there under the foundation, but now we have to run. We'll have to... or jump. We'll have to put up a couple of ramps there as well. Is that not even? No, it's even. I was just looking at it weird. All right. So then down over here, like a so, we will place a couple more of these guys. Like a so. And then that should allow us to build out a little bit. Like so, like so. So there, that's basically it. We got to put some ramps on the front so we can get up and down. But down right on this platform right here is where we can put up most of our stuff and things. Now, like I was saying, I'm a little bit concerned about any sort of animal attack in this area. So I'm thinking maybe we build, I don't know. We either put a turret up, but the turrets are scary. Because if they can actually kill your own dinos too. So we may just end up building like a box that we can put our guy into. Put our Anki into. Put Ingot into when he's up here and doing that. So one of the things I didn't take into account is that we need a couple of ramps. So I'm going to go ahead and get some of those ramps made. I'm just so concerned about the danger. Who are you? Mrs. Alpha. Who is this? Oh, it's Softus. Oh, this guy's all purple pinky. That's cool looking. All right. So we need some ramps up here, and then we can start placing all of the like items that we're going to have in here. And then I'm just so concerned about Ingot getting killed. We got to figure out a way to fix that up too. So I'm going to do a little bit of thinking, get a little bit of stuff and things built, a little bit more stuff and things built, and then I'll be BRBs, peeps. And we're back just doing some stuff and things, placing some stuff and things. And I was running into a little bit of an issue. You know, the other day I got to do a Q&A with the ARC devs, and it was really, really great. Like, it was so cool to see, like, get a chance to get inside their minds, ask them some questions. The community was there. We did it on Twitch, and I actually posted it to YouTube. If you want to take a look for it, it's like ARC dev Q&A stream or something like that. And anyway, one of the things we talked about in that stream was like building. And they were kind of like, well, what would you improve about the building? And I didn't really have an answer for them at that time. But just right now, I ran into something that kind of doesn't make any sense. I thought I'd show you guys. So for instance, right here, I cannot place a ramp. Right here, I can place a ramp. Right here, I cannot place a ramp. So like, why is that? You know what I mean? Like, that kind of doesn't seem to make any sense. No idea why that would happen, but I would really want a ramp here more than anything, since this is where I've decided to place this and really kind of need to have a ramp there. But it doesn't look like that I'm going to be able to. So it's one of those things where, you know, that's kind of some of the stuff that I would probably fix about this, especially this stuff where an item is kind of like or something that you're going to place is interacting with the ground or something like that. And you can't place it. So there really isn't that much of a reason why you shouldn't be able to place this here. And like you can see right here, I can place that. So obviously super obstructed by the ground. But you can't. So that's a little bit weird. So I'm wondering, even if I was to put like another floor or another ceiling, pardon me, do we have any on us? So let's just take a look here. If I was to do another ceiling here, then can I place a ramp down? So there I can. So you know what I'm saying? Like, that doesn't kind of make any sense. To me, at least. Now, let's see here. We've got, what, eight more ceilings. I always kind of want to call them floors. Eight more ceilings. So let's go ahead and pop these guys off. We're going to have to make more ramps. But at the very least now, let's go ahead and take these guys. Maybe we'll just make this a little bit bigger just so that aesthetically we can get the ramps we want to have. And then we'll drop that guy and drop this guy. And then like so and like so. And then if we could probably craft, what, two more ramps? And then pop these guys off. And then let's take a look here and see. So we can get one there. And now we can get one there. Now we can get one there. And one there as well. Whoops. Now, we might need a couple more just to make it aesthetic. Like, I wouldn't mind if we can place them right over here. That would look a lot better. Everything else matches up pretty good. So that looks really great. We got a little bit more room up here now. So that's baller. All right. Now it's time to place all the stuff and things. And we're back. And over here, as I was getting some wood, I noticed that there is a 112th level female Rex right in the area. Where is she? There she is right there. Now, Bluetooth is a dude. He's a dude. So I'm wondering if we could just land right up here. Fingers crossed on this one, big time. Wait, no, let's do a passive whistle on everybody. Thank you very much. Let's eat a little bit. Pull our spear out. Accidentally hit some wrong buttons. And then... oh yeah, baby, we got this right here. This is going to be so easy. Oh my God, we're getting into the Super T-Rex right now. We need a name for it. Maybe Wi-Fi, since we already have Bluetooth. I hope we have enough tranks. We had about, like, what, 75 or something like that? I think that should be a good amount. Anything super aggressive in the area? No. We got this Dilla right here. We could probably just take care of it right away. Now that ace can't be stopped. No, we didn't forget about you, young lady. Oh, was I hitting? I was hitting the rock? Oh, it looks like I did with a couple. All right, so we're going to go ahead and down this guy. I've been getting a bunch of wood ready because I figured that the best way to stop RGs and stuff and things like that from attacking Ingot when he's in the forge area is to just build a roof on it and build it as a real building as opposed to a platform. So I've been getting that stuff ready. I'm going to go ahead and tame this guy up. And really excited. This is cool. Opportunistic taming, peeps. All right, I'll be RBs. And we're back. And we got this T-Rex down over here. I got a ton of prime meat on it, ready to rock and roll. Been babysitting it a little bit. It's got a ton of meat on it as well. It's got 98.4% taming effectiveness. 155 is a 112, so 167 when it comes out, when it's done cooking. But I want to, like, be able to go, I don't know. I kind of want to maybe leave it. I don't know if I want to leave it or not. I kind of want to go and build and do stuff and things at the same time. I've been here now for probably about, I don't know, 30 minutes, 40 minutes watching it. I think we're going to do something new. I think we're going to try something a little bit new. I think we're going to try to take a chance. We're going to take a chance. So we've already got one T-Rex. It would be kind of a bummer if we lost this one. But, oh yeah, baby. We got our wolf, right? Melee damage, 693%. These guys are amazingly powerful. Amazingly powerful. So if we come over here, we actually hold on this guy. He's set for neutral. So we should be good to go. What I'm thinking we're going to do is leave him as a guard. So we're going to leave this guy like right here. So if anything comes around, it's most likely going to attack Hungry first. Like, well, maybe that's a little too far away. This is like a huge experiment. You know what will probably happen is nothing will attack it anyway. So we can leave Hungry like right here and he'll just stand guard. You gonna stand guard, buddy? Look at him, man. Look how hungry he looks. And he'll stand guard over this guy. And we should be have plenty of time on stuff and things. Everything should be good to go there. So, all right. So we're gonna leave that guy like that. And then we're gonna fly up. I got a bunch of building materials made for the new design. And I have an idea for a new design. I told you guys we're gonna put a top on the base. And then atop on the forge, the new forge area. And I think on tonnage over here is where I have all the stuff. So we've got 37 more walls. I built 10 window frames, the 10 reinforced windows. We got a couple of the sloped roofs, a couple of thatch roofs, and a couple of the sloped thatch roofs. So I think we're going to go ahead and take him up. Actually, what's his weight right now? 400, you know, just so that we can do this a little bit more quickly. I'm going to transfer all this stuff over to gameplay. We're going to fly up there and get a little building done, peeps. And we're back. I had to bring a couple dinos up. I couldn't carry all the stuff and things. I just couldn't do it all myself. So we got our dinos up here with us. We got a couple flyers. So what I thought we'd start off with, and I hope we have enough walls to do this. Now that I'm thinking I'm doing this, I don't think we're going to have enough. So that would be, these two would be four high. So what I'm thinking about doing is kind of like an A-frame style house thingy doodler, like so. Oh man, is that the one we needed to finish it? All right, probably not. All right, so then we can go like this, right? And then like this. Oh, baby, I think we got it. All right, so then we're going to grab these guys. That would be on this side. Like so. And then these guys on this side. Like so. That's going to be kind of a... Yeah, it'll be cool. It'll be neat. We'll see how it all works out. All right, so now we got to grab gameplay. We'll squirt these guys back on you. We've got our eight ceilings like so. Is that going to be enough? I hope it is. Let me take a look here. And I decided to do like a little thatch roof on it because I think that it'll look cooler. Like, I think it'll just be aesthetically, like, better. Oh, man, I built exactly enough. I'm super smart. All right, like so. And like so. And then I built a huge... I can't remember how many of these guys we got going on here. Let's take a look here. 20? Ooh, I don't know if that's going to be enough. And let me see. Can I place them from down here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Nailed it, Ace to Cabby Stop. Like so. Like so. Oh, I can't wait to get outside and see what this thing looks like. Oh, no, why? No, it's perfectly fine. No worries. Just destroy that guy right there. And like a so. So now we got like an A-frame thing. We got the small dino gate like so. Squirt that thing in there like that. You know what? Actually, we've got some windows we can play around with too. So let's grab these 10 windows and these 10 guys too. And then let's squirt some windows in here. Where do we think they would probably be the best spot for windows? Maybe we could do like one here and one here. Like so. And then another window. Like a little picture window area right there. And then maybe one right there and one right there-ish? I don't know. That's not bad, right? It's kind of cool. There's like one right there, one a couple right there, one over there. I like this. I like this a lot. All right, so now we will take these guys and we'll just squirt them into their correct spots. Like so. Like so. And we got our metal windows. We can just go ahead and open these up. They're just for looksies, really. Like so. And I'm actually thinking now, this might be kind of cool. Let's do one of these here and another one over here. And then we'll put the reinforced windows back in. Is that one already open? We'll open that one. And then back there like that. And I think that's a thing. Let's go ahead and get on to gameplay and take a fly around here and see what it looks like. I'm ready for the big reveal, peeps. Oh, baby, that doesn't look half bad, man. I really like the look of this place, man. It's a little mobile forge up on the top of the stuff and things. Like, it's all good to go. I think we could use another window on this side, maybe. Oh, yeah. This is looking great. It came out really good. I hope you guys like it, too. If you guys like the design, oh, look at that. It's pretty neat. Make sure you smash the thumbs up button if you like it, peeps. I'm thinking maybe another window. We got two more windows, right? I'm thinking maybe on this backside right here, too. Might not be bad to have something going on. Maybe we'll do another double, like so. And then we'll squirt these guys in here. Whoa, let me see if I can get up here to open these guys up. There we go. Then we get a couple more windows in the back there like that. And we got everything we need in here, peeps. Now we can go ahead and we'd have to go back down. Oh, I like that. And nothing's really going to be able to get in there. I mean, dinos could possibly damage it, I guess, because it's made of wood. But as long as it's, I guess maybe we probably want to close the windows. As long as nothing can see in, I don't think they'll aggro in there. So there would be no reason for anything to attack it. If we have a huge disaster, then it'll be a lesson learned. Stone would be perfect. And possibly over time, the more stuff and things we get, we could, you know, start building it out of stone a little bit too. Change over some of the wood into stone. But for now, I think that thing's pretty cool. All right, so we got to go get Ingot. We got to bring him up here. But we might as well go down now and check and see if our hungry like the wolf guard worked. If our guarding theory worked and our T-Rex hasn't taken any damage. Let's find out. And we're back. We got Wi-Fi, peeps. Oh, yeah. Tamed out at 166. Look at the size of a... Come here, girl. She's already following me anyway. All right, let's go ahead and grab gameplay. Our guard worked perfectly fine. Everything was good. Are you going to come over here, yo? I feel like she may be not the smartest lady ever. Look what I brought for you, Bluetooth. Look what I brought for you, man. Are you excited? Oh, you're so excited you got a level. Are you excited, buddy? Are you super excited? Oh, he's showing off for his girlfriend now. They're in love. Look how much in love they are. So exciting. Oh, you guys are so... They're kissing. They're hugging kind of like giraffes hug with her neck, except she's biting him. That may be a T-Rex mating type of thing. We possibly should maybe not be watching this right now. Pump a little bit of weight. Some hot weight action on Ingot. And all right, so the refining area, the new forge is ready to rock. We got our new T-Rex. I'm going to go ahead and take Ingot up there, and we're going to see how much metal stuff and things we can get one day. It's going to be quite a long walk, but I'm ready to make the journey. The journey of a million walks starts with a single walking stop start point and ends at the very last one. What? BRBs.
And we're back. The Mountain Forge on Ingot doing stuff and things. And I'm pretty excited, guys. You guys are going to check this out. So we're going to squirt him inside of here. But look what we got inside of here. 600 metal, 101 spark powder. What's inside of here? 600 metal, 101 spark powder. What's inside of here? You get the idea. 600 metal, 101 spark powder. Light it. Nailed it, ace. It can't be stopped. 612, 18, 24, 36. Wait, 612, 18, 24, 30. Pardon me. So that should be, what, 1,500 metal right there? And if you take a look out here, guys, I'm actually going to shut this down. If you take a look out here, look at this. I cleared the mountain in front right here, and then I started working my way up the mountain. Got up to right about this area here, but look at all the metal that's left. Like, it's insanity. Honestly, insanity. Like, the Anki is... I'm just trying to think logistically how this is all going to work once we get up here. Like, I think if we brought tonnage and poundage up and used them to ferry the metal back and forth, that would probably be the fastest way to do it, because Ingot just can't carry it. He just not big enough. He just doesn't have the weight to take it to the limit. But I got to tell you what, guys, I feel like we had a good day today. This is pretty crazy. What a great build. And I'm really excited because there's a new update coming as well. So there's going to be a lot more stuff and things in the future. But that's going to be it for today, ladies and gentle peeps. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to smash the like button. Yes, my face was painted red, by the way. And I think it wasn't Meal. I think it was Drax. And we're gonna take no retribution. We're not gonna take any retribution. We'll just file that away for in the future, so we know. Yeah, most Drax that call it us. But anyway, yeah. If you guys like the video, don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit.